We're solving equations with complex numbers here, equations that were previously unsolvable with real numbers, but we can do it now because we've got complex numbers. So I'm just going to solve this one. Z squared equals negative 16. Therefore, z equals the square root of negative 16. So z equals the square root of 16 times negative 1. That's plus or minus 4. And that is I. We have two solutions, both purely imaginary, positive 4i and negative 4i. I can draw them on an Argand diagram if I want to. There, at 4i, and 1, 2, 3, 4, at negative 4i. There are our two solutions to z squared plus 16 equals 0. Let's jump straight into this one. So 2z squared negative 6, z squared negative 6 divided by 2 is negative 3, z equals the square root of negative 3, which means that z equals root 3 times root negative 1, plus or minus. Let's put the plus or minus a step earlier, I think. Okay, so what we have here now is plus or minus root 3 I. And again, purely imaginary, we can put it on our complex number plane, on our Argand diagram, positive root 3i, negative root 3i. So a little more work to do in this example, 3z squared plus 5z plus 3 equals 0. I'm just going to use my quadratic formula here. So this is our a value, this is our b value, and this is our c value. We have negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2, 3. All right, and from there we can just sort of do some numbers. Okay, we can stop there. We've got two solutions here. Negative 5 plus root 11i over 6, and negative 5 minus root 11i over 6. So a little more complicated than these two, but same idea. We can actually put that on an Argand diagram if we want to, just as long as we write it just a little bit differently. And now we have negative 5 over 6 plus that, and negative 5 over 6 minus that, and we can put the real and the imaginary components on our Argand diagram. So you should see that these are skills that you already have. It's just that now that you know how to deal with a negative square root, you can now get one step further and give a complex solution. I'm going to make another video where we solve some more, but this time we're going to solve it using completing the square skill you already know. We're just going to apply it to this stuff.